With GitHub Actions, you can run pipelines manually and you can even set custom parameters for each single run. Let's see together how. Let's begin with this really simple action. The only keyword you're interested in is workflow dispatch in the triggers list. This means that the action can be manually triggered from GitHub. Everything else is just a single job which does something that is echoing hello I'm the trigger manually. Let's now go on the actions tab and see that we have this manual test voice in this menu. This also shows a blue banner which says this workflow has a workflow dispatch event trigger, and we have this button on the right to trigger the workflow. By clicking it, you will be able to select the branch that will be used to run your action. If for example you select a branch that does not have this workflow, GitHub will let you know with this yellow warning telling you that the workflow does not exist or does not have workflow dispatch in this branch, so it cannot be used. If we select again the main branch, which is the one with the workflow, we can click this green button and the workflow will be triggered. If we refresh the page, we can see that the workflow is now running, it's actually queued and will be executed in a few seconds. And if we go to check the logs, as simple as that, it ran our hello world job. Now, if by comparison we pick another workflow which does not have the workflow dispatch trigger, we will not see any blue banner here that we instead see on this trigger here. Going to the next level, let's see how you can pass parameter to this manual workflow. As you can see, this is the old repository used for the other video, so for now let's focus on only these two workflows. The first thing we need to specify after workflow dispatch on the triggers is the keyword inputs. Here we can put an array of inputs that will be used by our action. The first one, let's see, we're creating a custom build for one of our customers. We might want to specify the name. So it's a string and it's required true. Moving on, another input we might want is a boolean, because for example some customers might be premium and some might be not, so when we do our build we want to add or remove some specific feature. The third most common type is choice. In this case, let's say we have different themes and we want to have a default theme for our build. Instead of letting the user input a free string like we did for the customer name, we can ask GitHub to render a dropdown so that we can force the user to use only the valid inputs. With all that set up, we need our job. Let's call it build artifact, but it's a job ID, so you can choose whatever you want. It runs on Ubuntu latest as usual. And if you want to use these parameters, you can access them from github.event.inputs. And here you need to specify the same ID you added there. Let's now commit and push and see what happens on GitHub. Add workflow with inputs. Hit push. Okay, now if we refresh the page, our create custom build trigger appeared, and again we have the workflow dispatch event trigger, so we can trigger it manually. But this time, if we click here, we will see all our parameters, with the first being required, so there's this red asterisk. And for example, if I just click run workflow, it will immediately say that this field is required and I have to fill it. Let's say our customer is YouTube. We now have this boolean value that is a checkbox as we expected, and the front-end theme is a dropdown with light, dark and high contrast. If you remember, we had light as the default option, so when we opened the dropdown, light was already selected. If now that we've filled all the required field, we run the workflow. Again, we might need to refresh the page for the first time. Let's see our create custom build, how is it going? It's doing our build artifact job. And as you can see here, we asked to echo the three values, and this is YouTube, false and light. They are exactly the values we selected in the menu. Thanks for watching this video. If you're interested in more GitHub and open source content, you should consider subscribing to my channel. Also, if you want more tutorials specifically on GitHub Action, you should check out the playlist over here. If you also want to support the channel, please leave a like so that YouTube will recommend this video to other developers. Thank you very much and have a great day.